LE Audio is the next generation of Bluetooth audio. According to Sony, the biggest wireless audio challenge LE Audio addresses is streaming latency. In this video, we'll demonstrate how LE Audio reduces the audio latency. We have Apple AirPods Pro with USB-C, Bose QC Ultra Earbuds, Samsung Galaxy Buds 2 Pro, and WF-1000X Mark 5s to compare the difference. These earbuds will be connected to a Sony Xperia 5 Mark 5 running Android 13, and tested for the latency using superpowered Latency Test app. Before jumping into the earbuds, we want to show you the round-trip audio latency the built-in speakers of the smartphone produces. We have 29 milliseconds of latency from the speakers. If we subtract the 29 from the numbers we get later, we'll know how much the respective earbuds lag behind the speakers. Now we have Apple AirPods Pro with USB-C connected to a Sony Xperia 5 Mark 5 running Android 13 using AAC codec. We'll measure the latency using superpowered Latency Test app. We have round-trip audio latency of 243 milliseconds. We subtract the 29 from 243 to know the Apple AirPods Pro with USB-C using AAC lag 214 milliseconds behind the built-in speakers. Now we have Apple AirPods Pro with USB-C connected to a Sony Xperia 5 Mark 5 running Android 13 using SBC codec. We'll measure the latency using superpowered Latency Test app. We have round-trip audio latency of 225 milliseconds. We subtract the 29 from 225 to know the Apple AirPods Pro with USB-C using SBC lag 196 milliseconds behind the built-in speakers. Now we have Bose QC Ultra Earbuds connected to a Sony Xperia 5 Mark 5 running Android 13 using AptX Adaptive Codec. We'll measure the latency using superpowered Latency Test app. We have round-trip audio latency of 177 milliseconds. We subtract the 29 from 177 to know the Bose QC Ultra Earbuds using AptX Adaptive lag 148 milliseconds behind the built-in speakers. Now we have Bose QC Ultra Earbuds connected to a Sony Xperia 5 Mark 5 running Android 13 using AAC codec. We'll measure the latency using superpowered Latency Test app. We have round-trip audio latency of 374 milliseconds. We subtract the 29 from 374 to know the Bose QC Ultra Earbuds using AAC lag 345 milliseconds behind the built-in speakers. Now we have Bose QC Ultra Earbuds connected to a Sony Xperia 5 Mark 5 running Android 13 using SBC codec. We'll measure the latency using superpowered Latency Test app. We have round-trip audio latency of 330 milliseconds. We subtract the 29 from 330 to know the Bose QC Ultra Earbuds using SBC lag 301 milliseconds behind the built-in speakers. Now we have Samsung Galaxy Buds 2 Pro connected to a Sony Xperia 5 Mark 5 running Android 13 using AAC codec. We'll measure the latency using superpowered Latency Test app. We have round-trip audio latency of 274 milliseconds. We subtract the 29 from 274 to know the Samsung Galaxy Buds 2 Pro using AAC lag 245 milliseconds behind the built-in speakers. Now we have Samsung Galaxy Buds 2 Pro connected to a Sony Xperia 5 Mark V running Android 13 using SBC codec. We'll measure the latency using superpowered latency test app. We have round-trip audio latency of 214 milliseconds. We subtract the 29 from 214 to know the Samsung Galaxy Buds 2 Pro using SBC lag 185 milliseconds behind the built-in speakers. Now we have Samsung Galaxy Buds 2 Pro connected to a Sony Xperia 5 Mark V running Android 13 using LE Audio, or LC3 codec. We'll measure the latency using superpowered latency test app. We have round-trip audio latency of 179 milliseconds. We subtract the 29 from 179 to know the Samsung Galaxy Buds 2 Pro using LE Audio lag 150 milliseconds behind the built-in speakers. Finally, we have Sony WF-1000X Mark V's connected to a Sony Xperia 5 Mark V running Android 13 using LDAC codec. We'll measure the latency using superpowered latency test app. We have round-trip audio latency of 252 milliseconds. We subtract the 29 from 252 to know the Sony WF-1000XM5s using LDAC lag 223 milliseconds behind the built-in speakers. Now we have Sony WF-1000X Mark V's connected to a Sony Xperia 5 Mark V running Android 13 using AAC codec. We'll measure the latency using superpowered latency test app. We have round-trip audio latency of 268 milliseconds. We subtract the 29 from 268 to know the Sony WF-1000X Mark V's using AAC lag 239 milliseconds behind the built-in speakers. Now we have Sony WF-1000X Mark V's connected to a Sony Xperia 5 Mark V running Android 13 using SBC codec. We'll measure the latency using superpowered latency test app. We have round-trip audio latency of 245 milliseconds. We subtract the 29 from 245 to know the Sony WF-1000X Mark V's using SBC lag 216 milliseconds behind the built-in speakers. Now we have Sony WF-1000X Mark V's connected to a Sony Xperia 5 Mark V running Android 13 using LE Audio, or LC3 codec. We'll measure the latency using superpowered latency test app. We have round-trip audio latency of 83 milliseconds. We subtract the 29 from 83 to know the Sony WF-1000X Mark V's using LC3 lag only 54 milliseconds behind the built-in speakers. What can we tell from the test results? Well, AAC 214 milliseconds or SBC 196 milliseconds from AirPods Pro with USB-C are decent numbers, but cannot match the other low-latency codecs. You should pick them only if you have to use AAC or SBC, like using with an iPhone. AAC 345 ms or SBC 301 ms from QC Ultra Earbuds are quite bad, to be honest. But AptX Adaptive 148 ms is much lower than AirPods Pro, and you might want to consider them if you have AptX Adaptive devices. AAC 245 ms or SBC 185 ms from Galaxy Buds 2 Pro are decent numbers, and LC3, 150 ms is good. They're a better choice if you use a Galaxy phone or a Pixel phone, since neither phone supports AptX Adaptive. And finally, WF-1000X Mark V's LC3 54 ms is one of the lowest latency solution ever for Bluetooth audio. You should try them if you have LE audio devices. That's all for this video. Hope you get the idea on how LE audio reduces the audio latency. Thank you for watching.